firewalls can use different techniques to filter traffic, regardless if they are hardware network-based firewalls or software host-based firewalls. Packet filtering looks at each packet that enters or leaves a network. The firewall will permit or deny the packet based on user-defined rules, like source IP address, destination IP address, protocol, and port. Packet filtering can be further broken down into two subcategories. The first is stateless packet filtering, which is sessionless. Each packet is treated by itself as an isolated piece of communication. This requires less memory and time. There is low overhead and high throughput. However, this type of firewall technique cannot make complex decisions based on a communication stage. Just on access control lists, referencing IP addresses, protocols, and ports. If an attacker spoofs an IP address, a stateless packet filter can be fooled. Stateful packet filtering, on the other hand, uses sessions, can understand stages of a TCP connection, and can be aware of a hacker who tries to spoof an IP address. For TCP-based traffic, after a connection has been established, packets can flow between the hosts without further checking. An ALG, Application Layer Gateway, applies security mechanisms based on a certain application, like HTTP, SSL/TLS, FTP, DNS, and VoIP. So instead of just looking at IP addresses, protocols, and ports, ALGs look deeper into the protocols to see if they're being used properly. ALGs understand how specific protocols should work and look at layer 7. They can filter offensive or disallowed commands in the data stream. They are stateful. DPI, Deep Packet Inspection, is done by an ALG, Application Layer Gateway, to examine in great detail the contents of the data being sent. Some examples include making sure that data is sent in the right format and that there is no malware attached. Other uses include snooping and censoring. In fact, some ISPs have been known to use DPI, Deep Packet Inspection, to scan the contents of a packet and reroute or drop packets meeting certain criteria. High bandwidth communications like those involving Skype or YouTube can be prioritized over someone going to the RIT.edu website. In fact, ISPs in certain countries use DPI to look for keywords and web addresses for censorship purposes. DPI has actually evolved into DCI, Deep Content Inspection, which examines an entire file or email attachment looking for new generations of malware, for spam, for data exfiltration, for keywords, and other content. In other words, DPI, Deep Packet Inspection, just looks into the actual protocols and their behavior, instead of relying on just headers from the lower layers. That's great, but DCI, Deep Content Inspection, puts together parts of actual objects that are transmitted in parts of different packets, like PDFs and images. DCI even decodes and decompresses files. This is a much greater form of intelligence than partial data at layer 7 that DPIs deal with.